Hello dear students, well, welcome once again for the JavaScript tutorials. As you know that in previous session we have discussed about how to calculate factorial using JavaScript. So in this lecture we are going to learn, as you can see over here, JavaScript regular expressions. Now if you remember in the previous session, we have already gone through this particular topic named JavaScript regular expression. You may found this topic under W3 schools JavaScript regular expression object. So this particular topic we have already seen during my lecture. So if you scroll down, at the end you will find the complete JavaScript regular expression object. So if you go over here, we can see the complete reference of JavaScript regular expression. So today we are going to implement JavaScript validation using complete. So we are going to implement today JS validation. Now what is validation? Validation means when you are going to write any form, and if you want to validate that form data, we are going to use this validation concept. This validation concept in JavaScript can be implemented using JavaScript regular expression. So let us first of all have a program. If we want to validate this username, let us say enter over here some data, some password, and confirm password and click on submit. So it is saying that please check that you have entered confirmed password. So it is validating that I am not having entered the valid data. So how to implement this kind of program? So let us see the code. So as you can see over here, first of all, let me make a font somewhat visible. So as you can see that HTML contains only the form element for the output. In the form, we are having mainly three inputs. First of all, username as a type text, then password as a type password, and again confirm password to make sure that user had entered the correct password. So password field, and at the end the submit button. So we are having only total 1, 2, 3, and 4 controls on the web page. So this is our HTML part, and how to validate this, that is a script part. So this is the JavaScript. I have already implemented the JavaScript. Now let us understand how to implement that kind of functionality using JavaScript. So as you can see over here, on submitting this form, we are going to call a event on submit. And on submitting this form, we are going to call a validate form named function. So over here we are calling this function validate form. In this particular function, we had made all the required coding for validation of the data. So first of all, when we are going to call that function, it is passing the whole form as an object. So this is one method to pass the whole form as an object to the JavaScript function. Now if you observe, the very first block of code explains, if user has entered the username as a blank, then it should show an alert message that you entered the blank username. So how to validate that? For that we are having object form dot username. That is one of the element in the form, that is this one. In the UI session particular this. So if username dot value is a property for this username control, is equal to 0, then it is not allowed to submit the form, and it will show the alert message to the user that username cannot be blank. And again we are going to focus on the username field. So let us see that So if we left it blank and submit it, so it says error message, username cannot be blank. So it is executing this particular part of code. So it returns false, and again our focus is on the username field in the form. Now if this is not true, then first of all it will construct a variable re with this regular expression. Now DFN, this is the most important point in this whole video tutorial, that how we are going to understand this re variable or object. That name says re means regular expressions. We are over here builded a regular expressions to check that our username field contains letter, numbers, underscore character, all the things are there or not. If a username is having some letters, special characters and underscore, then the form is in the username form. So for checking that purpose, we are having a regular expression named with this. Now how we are going to understand this regular expression? So first of all, let us see what this wants to depict. So if let us go to the W3 schools for the reference. So if you observe regular expression object syntax, over here they have described that what do you mean by W. So W means find a word character. So if your regular expression having any letter, word, then it will find that character. The small W is for finding a word character, and capital W find a non-word character. So over here we had used the small W. So small slash W will find the regular expression which is having any letter value. Now what is the value of this particular character? So let us see that every letter in the regular expression having a specific meaning. So over here you can see that negate n, we can pronounce it as a negate n, that matches any string with n at the beginning of it. So if we are writing negate w in the regular expression, it means that your username must be start with the character, any letter should be there in the double in the regular expression. Now next is plus dollar. Now what is the meaning of this? Let us see. So over here you can see that dollar n, it means that matches any string with n at the end of it. That means our username must be ended with the string or character value. So our username must start with any letter. So once the regular expression is constructed, we are going to call a function test using the regular expression object, and we are cross-checking with the if condition that if regular expression dot test is equal to this, that is whatever we are inputting as a username over here in the form, that should follow the characteristic of this regular expression. So we are testing against this regular expression value entered in this username field. If that is not there, see over here carefully, we had used not character. So if this test results in false, if this whole bracket results false value, then user must be prompted with the error message, username must contain only letters, numbers and underscore character. If username is not particularly following this format, then username is not allowed. So in that case it will again focus on the same username field, and user is prompted to write down again the username. So this is, friends, really very crucial part in this whole video tutorial. The rest of the part is really very easy, and we can see that. Let's see that. So once this particular test has been passed, after that again another if condition for the password field. So what is the meaning of this condition? The meaning of this condition is that whatever the form object having PWD1 field and its value, that should not be empty. So in the password field, that is this one, whatever user enter as a password, that should not be empty. It is obvious that password should not be empty. So value of PWD1 should not be empty, and value of PWD1 should be equal to value of PWD2. We are confirming the password entered in this field and entered in this field should be similar one. That is why to make sure that we are going to evaluate this if condition, that password must not be empty and password in field 1 and confirm password should be the same one. If this follows, then we are again going to incorporate another if condition, that is we are emphasizing on the length of password. The length of the password must be less than 6. Oh my god, not must be less than 6. The password length, if it is less than 6 and not greater than and not less than 12, then that password is not allowed. If your password length is less than 6 or greater than 12, so we are imposing that kind of condition that your password must not be greater than 12 character and not less than 6 character. If it is there, then it again shows the alert message that your password should be of 6 to 12 character, and on the failure of that, we are again going to focus the same password field. After returning this condition true, once again we are checking the another if condition. So let me make it clear, if this condition is true, then we are checking first of all the length of the password. If the length is also true, then we are going to check for the value of the password 1 and username. If value of password field and value of username field, that means if password and username both are same, then it is not allowed. So we are going to again give the alert message that username and password must be different one. So this is one another check. Next check is again using the regular expression. Once we checked that it follows regular expression in username, we have to also check in password with the performed regular expression. So over here, this regular expression wants to say that any digit in between 0 to 9, this big brackets and 0-9 is the range that any digit in between 0 to 9 is allowed in this regular expression. So we are going to check if the entered password is not having any digit, then it says that password must contain at least one digit or number. So user is not allowed to enter any password that is not having the at least one number. After that, we are forming again another regular expression. Once this regular expression follows, we are going to follow another regular expression, that is it must contains character A to Z in small alphabet. So your password must contain A to Z character in small. So your password must contain at least one lowercase letter. If it is not, then it is going to show the alert message. After that, we are again imposing one more constraint, that is your password must contain at least one uppercase letter. For that, we are having this particular regular expression. We can see it in WC school also, that what is the meaning of this particular quantifier. let us see. Yes, over here. If you are writing in big bracket ABC, then it find character between the brackets. That means it is searching for the A, B and C character. If you are writing the range of character, then it will find any character in between the bracket. Over here it is digit. If you are writing A dash B in small letter, then it is find for small ABCD, and if it is in big letter, then it is find for second letter. So once this all test is going to be passed for the password, at the end we are going to check if this all condition is not going to be met, then we'll prompt that please check that you have entered the password, and confirmed password is also entered. That means if this all conditions is not true, this condition is not true, that means user must have not entered the password and confirmed password field. That is, these two fields must be empty and user had directly written some username and press the submit button. So in that case, username must contain only letters, numbers. So it is showing both the username error, and another one is we had also not submitted the password and confirmed password. So if we keep it is and submit, then it also check that you have, please check that you have entered the password and confirmed password field or not. So that's it. This is the code for confirming the username and password. And at the end, if we are entering the correct detail, then it will show the alert that you had entered the valid password. So this is it. This is how we can make the JavaScript program to validate the username and password using JavaScript regular expression object. Let us run the program. So I already mentioned the username. Next, let us enter password. So let me enter capital letter first, then two small letters, 1, 2, 3, and let us enter something different password over here and submit. So it says that please check that you have entered the confirmed password as the password field. So intentionally I had entered the wrong password. Now let us enter the right password. I hope I had entered the same one. Anyway, let us check. Okay, there is some mistake. Let us enter the password again, satisfying the constraint. So I am entering 1 capital letter, 2 small letter, 3 small letter, and 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 capital letter, 3 small letter, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I hope right now, yeah, so you entered a valid password, that is 1 capital letter, 3 small letter, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you can see that whatever consent I had set in my program, that all consent are satisfied by this password. 1 capital letter, at least 1 small letter, and at least 1 digit is there in the password, and password length is also greater than 6 and less than 12. So you can make your own constraints over here and make appropriate validation programs using JavaScript. We can see in future sessions that how we can validate live your password. That is, let us see, that is having a demo. So once you start entering your username, whatever over here, and password, you can see over here that as soon as I start entering the password, it show me that you are having a weak password. So as and when I start writing my password, it changes the suggestions that your password is strong enough. Now you can now proceed for the confirm password. So this kind of program we can implement using JavaScript. So for that, we'll meet in the next session. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.